Yo, what is going on, Guardians? J-Man here, and today we're going to be talking about one of the most unique and effective Hunter builds I've ever seen for PvE. We're going to be combining the powers of Stasis and Arc for the ultimate add clear utility, leveraging a hybrid elemental well and charge with light setup that will constantly feed into our abilities, and of course, doing big damage on those larger champions and bosses. This Ice Lightning build is by far the most in-depth technical build that I've ever created, and it's filled with synergies that could be used for any type of PvE content. If you're looking for an advanced setup that has a high skill ceiling and feels extremely rewarding to master, then join me as we dive into each component of what makes this loadout top tier, including a specific tutorial on how to master this build's gameplay loop. At the center of this build lies the exotic hunter helmet, the Mask of Bakras, supported by the Revenant Stasis subclass. Everyone remembers the fact that it replaces your dodge with a teleporting light shift, but what they forget is that after shifting, your arc weapons deal increased damage to combatants for a short time. There has never been a better time to explore the capabilities of Bakras than with the release of Arc 3.0, which is why my loadout consists of Tarnished Metal and Legend of Vakrius. I crafted my Tarnished Metal with Demolitionist and Jolt Shot to spread that jolt across adds, champions, and bosses, while also returning grenade energy. Legend of Vakrius is a heavy-hitting DPS option considering the buffs it receives from the Bakras Light Shift and the newly added Trench Barrel perk. And to round out the weapons, I crafted a No Reprieve with Pugilist and Headstone as an additional option to feed back into my Stasis abilities. Next, I'd like to discuss the setup of Aspects and Fragments. We're going to be leveraging Touch of Winter and Grim Harvest. Touch of Winter is going to enhance our Stasis grenades. For this build, we're using Dust Fields, which will grow in size and create a Stasis Crystal upon impact. Grim Harvest will create Stasis Shards when defeating slowed or frozen combatants, which returns our melee energy. To make collecting these Stasis Shards easier, we'll be using the Fragment Whisper of Conduction, which causes nearby shards to track to our position. A reminder that both our Dustfield Grenade and No Reprieve will be creating Stasis Crystals, which is why we can leverage Whisper of Chains for damage resistance, and Whisper of Shards to return grenade energy when we shatter those crystals. We can also return grenade energy when taking damage thanks to Whisper of Torment, and we can extend the slow from our Dustfield by using Whisper of Durance. Folks, if you made it this far, this is where the magic starts to begin. Let's go ahead and break down the armor mods that glorify this build. On our Mask of Bakras, we have a Stasis Affinity using Elemental Shards, making all of the shards we spawn with Grim Harvest count as Elemental Wells. I also slotted Power Preservation, which will spawn extra orbs of power on Super Final Blows. We also have a Stasis Cloak with Elemental Charge, giving us 2 stacks of Charge with Light when picking up those Stasis Shards. I also double stacked Utility Kickstart to help get our Bakras Light Shift class ability sooner. On a Void chest piece, we have Energy Converter, which will consume our stacks of Charge with Light when throwing a grenade, returning a boatload of Super Energy if and only if our Super Energy is below 50%. So, on my Arc Legs, I have the perk Heavy Handed, which also consumes stacks of Charge with Light on Shuriken throws, this time feeding ability energy right back into that melee. So basically, if you're below 50% super energy, you want to consume Charge with Light by throwing a grenade to refill your super. But if you're above 50% super energy, you want to consume Charge with Light with your melee ability, since Energy Converter will have no effect. And Heavy Handed secondary perk is a complete sleeper pick. While surrounded, defeating enemies with our shotguns actually adds ammo for that weapon right into the reserves. Last but not least, I slotted powerful friends in my Arc Arms to gain that passive mobility, while also giving nearby allies Charge with Light. That was a lot to take in. And as always, I have the dim loadout linked down below, but I do want to explain how the gameplay loop of this build actually works, since it is so complex. It all starts by throwing a shuriken, affecting adds with slow. Pick out a weak add and defeat it with a precision kill with no reprieve to create a stasis crystal from headstone, and return melee energy for your shuriken with pugilist. Use that stasis crystal for damage resistance and defeat the remaining adds affected by slow with tarnished metal, spawning stasis shards. These shards will automatically track to your position thanks to Whisper of Conduction, providing 2 times charge with light. You'll then want to throw a dust field at the next set of adds, activating Energy Converter, greatly regenerating your super energy. Reload your tarnished metal to activate Jolt Shot to spread lightning chains to take down large groups of enemies. Then, shatter your stasis crystals to return grenade energy. Continue this loop until you're above 50% super energy, and instead of throwing your dust field to consume charge with light, throw your shuriken instead to return melee regen. If at any point you need some bigger damage, use your light shift ability from Bokris, buffing the living hell out of Legend of Acrius for some big DPS numbers. Keep in mind that the buff from using Mask of Bokris with Light Shift is a stackable buff, so it does combine with Trench Barrel on Acrius, and would even stack with something like Well of Radiance. Last but not least, definitely let that Silence and Squall super go as often as possible, since you'll get it back quick thanks to Energy Converter, and will be spawning loads of orbs due to Power Preservation. Folks, that will conclude this killer of a build video, and if you made it to the end, I greatly appreciate it. If you have any ways to improve this build, please throw it down in the comments section below because I would love to make it even stronger. And if you enjoyed the gameplay in the video, feel free to help me out with a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the Cosmodrome.